6'5", 218-pound defenseman, has 168 hits on the season coming into this contest. And Steven Lorenz takes the draw at center ice. The Canes win it. It'll be batted around for half a second by Jakob Trenin. Kept in at the point by Ellis as his shot rings off the post early.
The warning call. Yeah, it looks like it hits something, and you can tell Peter certainly did low. Brady Shea getting some power play time on this abbreviated man advantage.
Aho goes around the board, settled by Pesci right on, and Saros makes the save. Penalty expires, and now Nashville. Yarncroke takes the puck into the Canes end. Sent it behind Peter Mraz instead. Pesci has to take a hit from Grassley. The puck comes free. Shot is spun and put right on. And if I know anything about you, Tripp, it's you love balance. Left, make sure it's all equal as the shot from Martinuk is spun and put right on Saros. He makes a save. Loose puck is picked up at the Canes' blue line and banked off of the boards by Cole Sissons, and he puts one off the side of the net. Mrazek will hold his post. Kick save and a beauty, but that's a toe save and a beauty for Mrazek. And now Nashville on the reload. Granlund comes in. That hits the pipe. Bounces up in the air. Mrazek off of his back. Stump chance. Great work by Shea on Granlund as Granlund was trying to knock on the door again. Trenin now gets it to the point. Shot is put right on by Benning. Deflected away from Mrazek. Nashville tries to go cross ice. Nobody's in front, so it goes from far to near boards. Captain at the point, though. Shot right on. And that's absorbed by the Carolina Hurricanes goaltender. Heads-up play by Pesci and Mrazek. That is, you saw Carolina looking to get on the board as the puck comes to the point. Hammered by Slavin. Rebound chance. And Svechnikov is robbed by Saros.
Reads the game so well. I mean, he doesn't have the size that Pekarinen, one of the great Finnish-born goaltenders. Here he reads that this is a shot pass to Svechnikov.
Just 10-2 in his last 10. He's on a five-game winning streak. Nashville sending the puck into the Hurricane zone. Sports shot right on, and Mrazek quickly with the glove will hang on to that. Set up there. Man advantage attack. Puck works his way across the Yarncroke. Yarncroke shot. And Mrazek gets an arm to it as Granlund was out in front. That goes out of play. For a big reason why. Most of the big dogs have been injured as now Canes and Mrazek played up the boards, and Jordan Staal goes and gets to it. Sends it out for Fogle. They score! What a setup! In his 1,001st game, Jordan Staal sets up Warren Fogle, and the Canes go up 1-0.
Now his puck handling, that's one of the reasons he wanted to be patient coming back from the thumb injury. And Jordan Staal took a look, I think, out of his right eye and recognized that the speedy Warren Fogle may beat Harper to the net. He saucered it. A lot of times when it goes through the paint as a goaltender, you want to get a piece. Well, I think they got a huge contribution from the penalty kill. They're still, I think, searching to try to find their team game. Those previous stretches, I like their team game a lot more than I did in the two games against Detroit coming into this one.
4-on-4 hockey, and the Canes start off and score! Andrei Svechnikov with a feed from Dougie Hamilton. And Carolina, 14 seconds into the second, goes up 2-0.
Takes a look like Jordan Staal and finding Fogle on the goal in the first period. Finds Andre, and what a lift this is going to give Svechnikov. To see one go in the back of the net between the arm and the body on the blocker side on UC Saros.
Now it's Svechnikov with room to work. Gains the Nashville zone. Puts it in the slot. Staal's shot right on. But Saros swallows that up. On a return feed from Svechnikov. Kept in at the point by Pesci. Bossed behind the Nashville net. In the zone. What a save! Saros robbing Aho on a one-timer on a great setup from Jesper Fast.
The initial entry that Andre should have been selfish and shot the puck, but you had puck retrieval. Jesper Fast finds Aho. Aho waves it zero time.
Gets to the loose puck, sends it over for Yossi. Now Sissons has it. He throws it wide. Rebound right on Mrazek! Robs Trenin.
What could have been 2-1? Mrazek has been dedicated using a vision therapy.
Along the boards, Natchez has it, trying to clear it. 1 foot pass hits Pesci, and he'll just get it over the blue line. Now the Canes make a play up for Trocheck. Trocheck thinks about a reach shot. Rebound, he scores! Saros couldn't handle the rebound, and Vincent Trocheck, he goes to 17 on on the season in the goal department. The Canes go up 3-0.
A track puck, so what could have been 2-1. Nice play by Martinuk. And yet, he's either trying to open him up to score the initial shot with that little pump fake, or create a rebound for himself.
Sent back down low for Holland. Holland fast. Fast tangling in the corner. Now starting and stopping his Cousins. Now right at the face-off circle, Mrazek flashing the leather as he robs Rocco Grimaldi.
Opposing team Nashville here tonight. Who's going? You have those choices.
Nashville wins the draw, gets into the slot, shot put on by Josi. Mrazek with the save. Follow-up opportunity is banked right on, and another save as Davies tried to bank one in, and Mrazek bannered about. Now the Canes will get to it as Fogle steps in and throws one across the blue paint. Stahl gets a stick to it, knocking it back to Fogle. Fogle from a sharp angle right on Saros. Secondary attempt is put on by Niederreiter, and that goes over the top of the net. Niederreiter. Stahl picks it up, tries to center it for Slavin. Slavin now behind the Nashville net, gets it out to Hamilton. Hamilton shot right on, and Saros makes the save. Hamilton gets it again. He's got a lane. He shoots, rips it off the post. Hamilton picked the far corner.
You see him, Beaver Tap calling for the puck. Slavin finds him, has Saros beat, and it catches the far post. So he has got right back on the horse tonight in a very impressive and I think in a lot of ways underrated manner so far.
We do have to have a bit of housekeeping when it concerns Peter Mrazek as third period's underway. Harper couldn't play it because it would have been a hand pass out of the zone, so the Canes are able to backhand the puck into the Predators end. Now Davies taken off the puck by Fogle for Stahl out in front. And Saros makes the save.
And Jordan Stahl and Warren Fogle. Warren Fogle cutting the ice in half, winning the board battle and finding Jordan Stahl. This is outstanding stuff to really just out-muscle Davies.
45 seconds have ticked off on this power play for Carolina, who just has an abbreviated man advantage tonight, 0-for-1. Now it's a breakaway, shorthanded. Holland coming in on Mrazek, shoots and he scores. Shorthanded breakaway goal for the former Carolina Hurricane, and Paula gets Nashville on the board. It's a 3-1 Hurricanes lead.
And Aho is guilty of turning the puck over. And the only defenseman got caught as Aho was turning it over. Harper makes a heck of a play. He has a ton of reach. Hey, that thing fluttered on Haula, it looked like. Yeah, I mean, that thing is wobbling, then it settles.
When you go back to the trade deadline last year, as now Holla steps into the game zone. Shot put right on Mrazek. Two saves, denying Eric Holla another goal here tonight.
Tally earlier this period.
Again, on the season, the Canes come in with a number one ranked power play. Now Svechnikov with the wings, gets it to Trocheck. Trocheck has to wait, sends it across, they score! Sebastian Aho on the power play. Makes it 4-1, and that could be the dagger.
Slides down. Much like a recent, the last power play goal against Florida. It didn't require the patience that this one did from Trocheck to Aho, but it's the same two ingredients. Oh my gosh, what a job by Vincent. Holding, drifting.
Asheville pops it into the Canes end with 4 seconds left, 3 seconds left in this one. Dougie Hamilton has the puck on his stick. The clock hits zero, and the Canes get a two big points.